Let me see your hands. Look at these hands right there. 2,500 bulbs they planted.
Yes, 2,500.
That's ridiculous.
About 2,000 in the ground and about 500 in pots.
That's a lot.
I'm almost finished.
I would hope so.
And I'm ready to be finished.
Yeah.
Okay, so why would you put them in pots?
Tell me.
Well, number one.
Because you've run out of dirt.
I've literally run out of real estate in my own garden.
I know you have.
But I love pots because you can put them in areas where they really pop, where you really want to have some extra, you know, definition or color.
Nice.
And because I can bring some of them indoors.
And because you can.
And because I can, you know, if a lot is good, then thousands are even better.
Now, she kind of fooled me because I thought these were some type of huge
These are little species tulips.
Tulips?
Yes.
I didn't know that. They're smaller.
They're called Turkestana, and they are kind of an atypical looking tulip. The bloom on them doesn't look like a traditional tulip, but you'll notice that the blooms or the bulbs themselves are also smaller.
I thought they were crocus. They're not, though.
They're not. But let me tell you, I planted crocus, grape hyacinths, tulips, and some miniature daffodils all in pots, some really large ones that are at home in my garden right now, but also these smaller ones that I plan to bring inside. And it's really so easy. And, you know, think outside the box. You don't have to use just traditional terracotta, though I love that look. You can also use things that are a little bit more innovative. This is an antique colander.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes,
that's,
it's got small holes on the bottom. I don't know if you can see it. I won't.
I'm worried.
But great drainage. This is just a wooden box that I drilled holes in. So you can be a little bit more creative and think about, you know, where they're going to be inside your house when you put them on display. And then basically it's as easy as just taking a really light, loose soil. And here's a tip.
What?
Don't get a potting soil that's really, really heavy. If you do, mix it with some peat moss or something that's a little bit lighter, because what they really don't want to be is waterlogged.
Okay.
And if the soil is too heavy, it will hold too much moisture and that might, you know, make them prone to rotting. So use something that's a really light mix.
Okay, now we're not pushing any brand, but are you talking like a Miracle-Gro brand? Are those too heavy?
This basically is a soil conditioner that I just mix with some peat moss.
Oh, okay.
And, but yeah, if you use Miracle-Gro, just mix it with something lighter. Mix it with
this kind of soil.
Peat moss is lighter, and it will just reduce the physical weight of it, but also it will just help the drainage. And then what you want to do is, again, be creative about what kind of container that you use. Make sure that it's got good drainage and make sure that it's at least deep enough so that the tulip bulbs or whatever bulbs you're using has sufficient root growth, because you're going to plant them at about the same depth that you would in the garden.
Don't you need about 2 inches?
You need about 2 inches or 2.5 times the depth of the bulb. And then we're going to make sure that we put that much soil on top.
You'll notice 2 inches?
Same. So if this is the depth of the bulb, we're going to plant them about this deep.
Okay.
So then we're just going to kind of tuck them in. You don't want any more distance than about 1/2 inch in between the bulbs. We want them to be really densely planted because we want a really dramatic show.
But with all bulbs or just these?
All bulbs. And you know, you can mix bulbs, but I find it's better to stick with a single kind. You get
just
a little bit more drama.
Yeah. Now, if you want to see drama, you've got to go to her website. It's lindavotter.com. You can also follow her on Instagram at Potager Blog. She's fabulous. Thank you for coming.